We've been using a potted raspberry culture system to evaluate different raspberry genotypes in a small space. So this is in a high tunnel. We've been growing a number of different cultivars as a way of evaluating quickly the quality of the berries, the productivity of the plants, and even the disease and insect susceptibility of the different genotypes.
We'll be describing the characteristics of several newer varieties. This chart illustrates the relative times of harvest for the primocane fruit, and these are relative times for southern Michigan under a high tunnel. The first variety is Joan Jay. This is an early primocane fruiting type that begins fruiting for us in southern Michigan in early August. It's a highly productive primocane fruiter, but only a modest floricane fruiter. The berries are very firm with an excellent flavor. They are somewhat darker than some customers would like. The canes are thornless, which is appealing as well. The second variety is Polka, and Polka is an early season type that begins fruiting on primocanes during the first week of August in southern Michigan. It's a highly productive primocane fruiter and a modest producer on floricanes. The fruit of Polka are a bright, glossy red, very attractive. The flavor is good as well. Imara is a very new variety that was developed in Europe, and we're very excited about it. The season for the primocane fruit is mid-season. It appears to be very productive on both primocanes and floricanes, so it could be double cropped. The fruit are very large. They have a very glossy appearance and a medium red color. They don't tend to darken in storage. Flavor is exceptional. They have some moderate tolerance to gray mold. Kweli is another very promising new variety that came out of Europe. It's a mid-season type. It's very productive on both floricanes and primocanes. The berries are very large to large in size, excellent firmness, a bright red color, and excellent flavor. They seem to have a moderate tolerance to gray mold as well. Kwanzaa is a new late season variety from Europe. So the primocane fruit begins maturing late enough in the fall to where primocane yields may be poor in short growing season areas. The floricane yields are exceptional, however. The fruit are extremely large and very firm with an excellent flavor. They have a bright, lighter red color, which many in the markets appreciate. They also have a very long shelf life, so they seem to retain their quality in storage for a considerable time. Our early trials with these three new varieties from Europe are very promising, Imara and Kweli being the earlier primocane fruiting types and Kwanzaa the later fruiting type. The last two varieties we'll talk about are Crimson Knight and Double Gold. These are late season types. Crimson Knight probably will not produce high yields on primocanes in short growing season areas like Michigan because the harvest begins too late. It may produce higher yields in longer season areas. The berries of Crimson Knight are a beautiful uniform color and shape. They have a wonderful flavor and are very firm. They have a moderate gray mold tolerance. The name Crimson Knight comes from the fact that the berries are very dark crimson red in color. The last variety to talk about is Double Gold. This is a late primocane fruiting type, so it will probably produce poor yields on primocanes in short growing season areas, but the yields on floricanes seem to be substantial. It has a nice uniform shape and a unique champagne pink color. The flavor is somewhat unique also, but excellent. Medium firmness. It has a modest tolerance of gray mold. It does have one problem of susceptibility to sun scald. So if the berries are exposed to bright sun, some of the color in the drupelets on the berries will be affected.
Thank you for watching this Tunnel Berries video. For more information on berry production in both high and low tunnels, visit the Tunnel Berries website or follow Tunnel Berries on Facebook and Twitter.